On my Instagram, if you had any questions related to PCOD, because I did make a video on PCOD quite some time back and I thought I should do like an update version. So I have my doctor with me. She's Dr. Neha Giran. She's the one who has been treating me throughout my PCOD. So I'm really thankful to her for that. And I got it in this video just to make sure that I can get your questions answered by an expert. So I'm going to be going over about 20-25 questions, small little questions, which you guys have put forward. And I'm not going to be taking any names or anything whatsoever. So yes, she'll be the one who's going to be answering your questions. So I'll go and I'll ask her a few questions now.
Sure.
So the first question, and something that has been asked a lot of times, is does it take time to go, like PCOD, does it take time to go, and if it can be cured permanently, because people are not able to conceive because of that.
See, what is PCOD? PCOD is basically, if we do the abbreviation into an elaboration, it's polycystic ovarian disease. What happens is, when a girl is maturing into a woman, the ovaries are actually developing. And mostly what happens is, during this development phase only, minor follicles come up in the picture. What happens is, when this functioning is abrupted, mainly because of the pituitary gland, some hormonal imbalances also happen in the body. So it's a very insidious as well as a very gradual process. So if you are looking at the cure of the disease, it is going to be very, very insidious, gradual, and yes, it can be cured with homeopathic medication as well as good lifestyle, good diet and exercise. It can be totally eradicated.
Okay, so and what about the problems in conceiving? How can that be cured? Because if it's a process that takes time and someone wants to conceive in a, say, about a year or two, then what can they look at?
See, again, I am basically going to emphasize on the lifestyle changes also, along with homeopathic medication. Why? Because the origin of the problem is lifestyle issues only. Or heredity issues also come into picture, or extreme stress factors, or some psychological illnesses which have been creeping can play a role also.
Okay.
So the thing is, meditation, calming down your mind, and having a career or having something which can, you know, boost up your self-esteem, plus your good lifestyle and homeopathic medication, can cure a PCOD patient varying from 6 months to 1 year. Totally.
So you're also trying to say that it's really important to know what is the root cause of the PCOD.
Yeah.
Because it will differ from person to person, and then the cure will also differ from person to person.
Yes. That is what all homeopathy is about. What happens is, if we are having headache or fever, generally the mode of treatment in other sciences is fever ki dawai de do. But in homeopathy, what we do is that we basically, if the person is coming to us with arthritis, not only we are curing the arthritis problem, but we are going into the individualistic symptoms also. The individual who is suffering from a chronic ailment will always be different. So different medication.
Okay. So guys, the first and foremost thing is, discover why you have PCOD in the first place and bring a lifestyle change. That is the most important thing. Before medicines, I think lifestyle change is very important.
It's very important because that's the origin
of it. Alright, so another question that people have is that they have really heavy and thick facial growth, especially on their upper chin and upper lip area.
Yes.
So why only this region, and what can be done to cure it?
See, this is a common problem. It's actually a manifestation of the disease which is happening. What happens is, there are hormones in the body. The girls are supposed to be having very low concentration of testosterone hormone in the body. But because
which
of
is a male hormone.
Yes, it's a male hormone. And in PCOD, this imbalance occurs. And because of this testosterone being in larger quantities, age-appropriate quantities, this happens as a manifestation, and it actually ruins the self-esteem of the girl.
That's what the question is. I'm really embarrassed by this facial hair growth.
Yes.
Even I have a lot of facial hair growth. I used to have more than what I have right now. I have seen that once you start, you know, taking care of yourself, not only just facial removal, but once you exercise and everything, this hair growth does go down.
Yes, it goes down. Why? Because the imbalance is being corrected by your lifestyle changes plus exclusive homeopathic medical combination of medicines is available. If a PCOD person is coming to me with just menstrual irregularities, I have different medication. If she's having facial hair growth, that's a different combination available. If bloating is there, the medicine differs.
So there was another question, and I was so surprised to see that there is such high level of unawareness regarding PCOD. So one of the person asked me, does ultrasound detect PCOD effectively, or is there any other way to detect PCOD? And if a dermatologist does it or a gynecologist does it?
See, you know what? When a girl walks into me, a typical adolescent girl who's not married, and she's having these manifestations, slight amount of acne is there, irregular periods is there. This clinical manifestation itself is talking that some hormonal imbalance is there. And to get an ultrasound done is actually not very useful. Why? Because it's not going to be a TVS, it's not going to be a transvaginal scan which is being going to done for an unmarried girl. So the accuracy of the results is again a question mark. But yes, with ultrasound we can be having some ideas. With the blood test we can have some ideas. But I have also studied, because of my clinical experience, that girls who get these scans done, are emotionally it takes a toll on them.
Yeah.
That they feel a stigma. They feel that something is wrong with them and they are different from the others. So when girls come to me, I prefer not to get the scans done, very repeated scans, and to be actually counseling them that they'll be fine.
And okay, it's not like a disease.
Yes. And plus, you should not feel that you have a, you know, it's like a stigma that your womanhood come over. Because you're finally going to get it back with these medications plus the lifestyle changes.
Yeah, there is hope. That's what I was surprised about, because there's such huge unawareness about PCOD and people are not ready to talk, as if it's a stigma.
It's a hush-hush thing.
Yes. I was really surprised. Even when I did my last PCOD video, I got so many comments that, you know, I didn't know what PCOD was and I never knew why my periods were irregular, and then I got my scan done and I got to know. So it is just, it's really surprising how unaware we are as a society.
Yes, and the onus is more towards the parents, because they should be actually, you know,
talking to their kids.
And they should make the children more bold enough to be expressive and actually talk about the
problems. Even if not expressive, at least comfortable to talk to them that, you know, I'm not having regular periods, I think something is wrong. At least to their parents, if not to anyone else.
This will be actually a boost to the self-esteem and make the person more vulnerable to recovery. Faster recovery.
So another question that is major concern for a lot of girls is that how to tackle weight gain. So someone is also asking that they hardly eat, but they're still gaining weight. Again, not eating is not the way to lose weight.
So such a wrong notion.
Such a wrong notion.
Yes, you are depriving your body and giving the body a signal that yes, I'm going to deprive you. So what happens is, as it is, if the person is having PCOD, the metabolism is going for a toss. And if you're not eating, then metabolic rate further dips on and the body gets a signal. It's going to be deprived of nutrition and it's going to store the fat and all the reserves. What the trick to the solution is eating right, eating small portions, eating at small intervals, and eating more. You have to have a carrot, you have to have nuts in your bag, and you have to have a charge. You know, you have to pick the right options. And constantly feed the body. And
it's
drink
really
a lot of water.
It's important to, you know, not starve yourself when you have PCOD. Like, that is such a wrong approach. Even for normal weight loss, even if you don't have PCOD, starving your body is not the way to go.
It's not the way to go. Basically, carb has to be cut down. Obviously, people know about fat, sugar, processed food. But we don't know that even rice and chapati are making us fat. You know, simple ras and chai le re, and, you know, empty calories going.
Empty calories.
So that's there.
Some people have also want to know that does PCOD also affect your height as it affects your weight?
No, it doesn't.
It doesn't. Thyroid does affect your height.
Yes, it's a growth hormone. So the thing is, whatever your genetic makeup is, you are going to gain the complexion, the height, everything. But it's in your hand to enhance those things, you know? Mm-hmm. 2 months of good exercise can actually change you as a person totally. and believe you me, you just have to do it to believe it.
Believe it. And anyway, exercise does release like happy hormones from your brain, so that really impacts on you as a person as well.
Yes, and you can harness the best out of you with good food and exercise. And obviously, homeopathic medicines are going to correct the hormonal imbalance because of the disease, regularize the periods, and rest of the job, part of the homework has to be done.
Done by you. So another thing, that this is a question from my side, I know a lot of girls would be, you know, curious about this, that how does allopathic medicine affect their body through PCOD? Because a lot of girls have asked me that they take that pill through which they do not take for 21 days and then they have 5 days or 4 days of periods and then they take those pills again.
Yeah.
So at least I, for a person, know that that's going to affect you in the longer run, and these are unmarried girls I'm talking about.
Yes.
So what effects do they have on your body, if you can explain to, you know, everyone? Because see, I know there's going to be a lot of unawareness about this.
See, it's a very, very sad thing that these girls are taking this medication and they are being prescribed. What happens is the body is being given a crutch. Dependency is created. There is a signal which is being given to the body that the ovary is not allowed to function on its own. What happens is every 25, 28, 30, 35, depending upon every individual, the ovary is releasing an ova. And that ova, because it is not getting fertilized, is finally bursting and periods happen. So what happens is, if there is irregularity in ovulation as well as maturation of the follicle, and what happens is every cycle the ova is released, but sometimes because of PCOD, this hormonal imbalance, this cyclic release of the ova is disturbed. But if we are providing a crutch to the body will be totally dependent. So what we have to do is, in homeopathy, we are boosting the immunity and making the ovaries let their function be done on themselves. No crutches being provided. Plus, these are contraceptive pills. The contraceptive pills are making the person not only dependent, plus they are giving you a withdrawal bleeding, which is not as a normal menstruation cycle is happening.
Okay.
One. Second, these medicines have their own kitty of side effects which they carry along.
Weight gain,
long-term liver carcinoma, breast carcinoma, migraine, everything. So the thing is, it makes your body, it creates a havoc in the body. This is the worst thing that can be done to a girl, to be, you know, be prescribed with these oral contraceptive medicines. And this is no cure for PCOD.
This is no cure.
This is just going to regularize your periods on the face of it.
These are not even periods. Yes. They're just withdrawal bleeding.
Yes.
It's not a proper period. The body's not getting cleansed.
You are having a headache and you are taking a painkiller. The headache is there, but
it is suppressing it.
But the nerves are becoming numb and you're getting suppressed. So you have to treat the sinus which is causing the headache.
Yeah.
So origin.
Origin again. Origin is really important. Alright, so another question that a lot of girls have is that, again, due to these pills being taken, will they have issues in conceiving later?
Of course. These pills, these contraceptive pills, in general, even if a married girl is taking them as a contraceptive measure, they are advised to be, you know, off these pills for at least 6-7 months before they start planning a baby.
Okay, so that your body can go back to normal.
Yes, the normal rhythm. So the thing is, when they are unmarried, and since then, if they are taking these medications,
like young girls, 13, 14 years,
it's very unhealthy.
Very unhealthy.
Instead, the doctors should actually, you know, shout at the top of the volume, please exercise, please eat right, please have water, don't take stress, and be positive, do meditation, and things will fall in place.
Alright, also, some people wanted to know, is like extreme PMS or premenstrual syndrome a symbol of someone having PCOD?
Need not be. Actually, premenstrual syndrome is also hormonal fluctuations are only happening in the body, but it's a normal thing. Some people will experience more symptoms, some people will experience less symptoms, but the good way to handle is, if you're really actually becoming sick, you can go in for homeopathic medications. But if it is manageable, it is better to take lifestyle changes, you know, have a herbal tea, do yoga, do muscle, stretching, and you'll be fine.
Yeah,
so fermentation.
Extreme PMS need not be a sign of PCOD. Yes. A lot of girls are asking this question.
It's like a myth.
Yeah. Then again, the most asked question, acne. Like, why does acne occur when PCOD, or is there a typical type of acne that happens during PCOD which can detect PCOD, mm-hmm. and what to do of that acne?
See, what happens is PCOD is striking when the girl is becoming a woman. She's growing up, and that is the time adolescence is happening. Boys and girls, both of that age, are experiencing puberty, and acne happens. Why? Because there are glands. The sebaceous glands become very active. Sebum is released. Plus, what happens is this youth has got erratic hours to sleep and junk food, pizza and pasta and all this stuff is going in the body. So this acne becomes actually a nuisance. So need not necessarily be that acne is a clear cut. If you have acne, then PCOD. It need not be like that. But yes, if the acne is really bad, we get an indication that hormonal fluctuations are happening in the body and some amount of imbalance has occurred.
So is there a typical type of acne as well? Like, there's cystic acne and then there's other type of acne. So is there a typical type of acne that happens when a person has PCOD?
No. What happens is, when you are having acne rosacea or any other simplex or any other acne, this sebum, which is getting overproduced because of this hormonal imbalance, will have variations irrespective of PCOD or not.
Okay.
So, to prescribe PCOD medication on acne is actually not correct. First 2-3 months you should prescribe just homeopathic medications for acne and do the lifestyle changes, and then see. And after, if you're not getting results, then you should probe.
So someone wants to know that they have really long periods, that is about 10 days, and it's really painful. So what to do to cure that?
Okay, and how old is she?
She didn't mention that, but she said that she is been detected with PCOD.
Okay. See, if she's unmarried girl, then it's actually very, very common to have dysmenorrhea. Dysmenorrhea is the medical term for the painful periods. What happens is that because of lack of hormonal proper rhythm in the body before marriage, this dysmenorrhea is a common feature, and she can go in for homeopathic medications. Very good homeopathic medications are available. But if she is married and she is still experiencing that, and she has PCOD as well, then the medications will differ. But again, homeopathy can be the answer.
So, what are some of the foods that you would really like recommend people to have if they have PCOD? Because as I said, lifestyle change is very important. So, you already told that we should cut out carbs, and then you should have carrots and nuts.
Yes.
So what are some other foods that we should include in our diet to help in, you know, aiding our PCOD?
See, basically, pani nahi peete.
Nah.
20 glasses of water to start with. Children are coming to me. 2 glasses, 3 glasses, you know, you're not detoxing your system. This is the basic rule. Then comes a lot of fiber in the diet. Fiber in the form of fresh green vegetables and fruits, be it sprouts, be it salad, be it just like, you know, munching away.
Not just McVitie's fiber biscuits.
No.
Those are just like
totally out of option.
Out of option.
Yeah. So you have to focus on the colored foods. Like, you have to have a green colored, you have to have a yellow colored capsicum, you have to have a green colored guava, some papaya. So antioxidants are getting installed by the different colors, and they are very rich in the micronutrients which these kids are eventually getting deprived of because of the lack of nutrition in the body. Second, third is lot of protein, because bodybuilding tissues are being required. You're going to exercise, so you have to have, if you are a non-vegetarian, you have good options, like you can go for egg whites, fish is a very good option, lean chicken is a good option. For vegetarians, tofu, soya bean, kala chana, and, you know, legumes, that should be taken in bulk. Plus, again, exercise and good sleep in a proper circadian rhythm, which will make the absorption and the assimilation of these nutrients easy for you.
And what are some exercises that you recommend, like yoga, aerobics, gym? What is something?
Anything which is enhancing your blood circulation and making you happy.
And anything can the person be regular in? Because sometimes we take up gym membership and we like never.
It should not be a homework. It should be very fun. You should look forward to it. Why? Because as when we are born, we are taught how to brush karna hai. You know, you have to bathe. So this should be the third thing. Hum exercise karna hai. It should be like that.
And if you're looking forward, our brain will be happy as well, and hormones again. It's all in a cycle.
It's all in a cycle. Less of gizmos, more of outdoor activities, more of, you know, social interaction, less of depression happening, and, you know, self-esteem going up. All interrelated.
All interrelated. Yes. And what are some of the other diseases that are linked to PCOD as well? Like some combinations and anything?
Yeah, thyroid.
Thyroid.
The most common is thyroid because, again, hormonal imbalance. Thyroid is what? Thyroid gland is generally, girls come to me with hypothyroidism, which is the TSH, the thyroid stimulating hormone, that goes up in the body.
Okay.
So thyroid stimulating hormone means the thyroid gland has to do a lot of work to generate T3 and T4. So to vitalize your thyroid gland, again, homeopathic medication plus these lifestyle changes will make you get rid of thyroid in combination with PCOD. Otherwise, the option is, the girls come to me, 25 mg Thyronorm, then 50 mg, then 75 mg. Eventually,
going up and
the
up
dose is going up, and you are not realizing again that the body is getting a crutch. The body is further weakening, and you are orally supplementing it from externally, and the side effect of that Thyronorm or Eltroxin is the bones are actually very brittle, osteopenia, osteoporosis happens.
And
it's a vicious circle.
It's a vicious circle. And also, I think we'll end soon with some little more questions. So one another question is hair fall.
Yeah.
So there's hair growth happening on the face and hair fall happening
on the scalp.
So why does that occur, and what to do to like cure it again?
Yeah, again, it's a manifestation. What happens is male hormone, hairline starts receding, like male pattern baldness happens. So hair fall is happening. So what is the answer to it? You are given homeopathic medications. Once the imbalance in the hormones and the cyclic release of ova happens, your hair fall stops. So
again,
it's again a manifestation.
So it's all happening because of testosterone and
the imbalance
in our body.
It's happening because of the imbalance. Imbalance in the body, which is created, has to be cured with the homeopathic medications as well as this lifestyle changes, be it acne, be it hair fall, be it bloating, be it irregular periods, be it a later on manifestation which is in the form of infertility. So everything is actually shooting out its branches if it is not curbed in the initial stages.
So I would like to end by you giving out advice to all of the young girls out there. Do not feel ashamed of this as a disease, or I'm not fine, because I've seen so many girls who are like, no, I can't talk to it about anyone. You know, if you can just keep me anonymous and get it answered. So I thought I'd keep it anonymous, but I still feel that we shouldn't be ashamed of it. And we should at least talk to our parents, go to a family doctor or anyone. And I'm sure Dr. Nay is like always available. She's been really nice and kind with me throughout my treatment as well.
And see, what happens is, this is part of your treatment. The first time you are going to actually look in the mirror and say, yes, I am a PCOD patient and I am ready to handle my disease, which is curable, and I am going to emerge as a winner. This is the first step to acknowledge the disease and then to talk about it. You have actually started winning the process. Why? Because if you're not acknowledging it, you're shoving it under the bed and you're hiding, and you're just, girls come to me and say, mujhe sirf acne ki medicine chahiye, you know, and I'm just bothered about my weight gain. You have to treat the origin. You can't shirk away from the origin and not accept the problem. And you know what? This will actually become a bigger demon and stand in front of you one day.
And even if you don't, like, you know, if you just take a topical medicine for acne and you just get rid of that one pimple, it will come back because you haven't.
Yes, the demon is going to come back. Why? Because the origin has not been
cured.
First confronted, acknowledged, and then starts the cure process. So please don't lose hope. It's not a stigma, and the cure is available. with homeopathic medication and proper counseling.
Proper counseling, lifestyle and everything.
Yes.
So yes, I hope this video was helpful and you got answers to all of the questions that you had in mind. And I will leave all of the details of Dr. Neha in the bottom bar so you can contact her if you want to come to her, take medicines, counseling or any sort of advice from her. And I will see you guys next time. If you have any other questions and if you want me to do another video with something more, something else with her, then do let me know as well. I hope she will be up for it.
Of course.
And I will see you guys later. Till then, take care. Bye.